Hello everyone. So today we will study about the date of Qiyamah, that means the judgment day, and how it is mentioned into the Quran and how it is interlinked with the verses and with the natural and prime numbers. So these are the some of the natural numbers you can see from number 1 to number 67. As for the example, we have taken the prime number out of this 67. There are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. These are all the prime numbers, and below is the position of that prime number. So here we can see that the 19 prime number has the position 8. Same way the 67 prime number has the position of the 19. So these are the sequence and respective the position of that prime number. Same way, if we remove from this natural number, if we remove the prime number, then the remaining numbers are the composite number. As the one number is neither the prime or nor the composite, so we can start like 4, 6, 8 and 10, and if we count, then there are the between 2 to 67, if we take suppose as example, then there are 66 composite number and the position 47. Same way there is 30 composite number and position is the 19. Same prime number and composite number we can check from this program. Suppose this is the composite number program. So if I am typing here the up to the 67, then it will find all the composite number respective the its position. So you can see here that 66 has the 47 position. You can see here 66 has the 47 position. So same way we can derive the many other composite number and respective positions, and same we can derive it with the prime number as well. If I type here the 1000, then it will take the all the prime numbers up to the 1000 and respective its position. So here we can see that 19 has the 8 positions. Same way 67 prime number has the position 19. So this is the program we have already made, and this is actually we are explaining that how the judgment day it's correlated and how it's precise that God has mentioned into the Quran that the next 267 years after the judgment day means there will be nothing left into the earth. So before going to that, we will see in the Quran where it is mentioned and how it is hidden. So Surah 20 and verse 15, it is mentioned that the hour is surely coming, I will keep it almost hidden, for each soul must be paid for its works. And the second verse where it says that we have given you the seven pairs and the great Quran. We will see these verses. So here it is clearly mentioned the hour has surely coming, I will keep it almost hidden, for each soul must be paid for it work. So here it is actually described about the judgment day, means the date, the Qiyamah, or you can say in a judgment date. So here the 20th century as per the solar calendar, and 15 is mentioned as per the lunar calendar. So 20th century, so when it will be revealed out, so these are as per the solar, and 15th century is as per the lunar calendar. So we know that there are the two types of the timing and date are actually mentioned, you can count it like 365 days as per the sun, rotate, these are the sun and these are the earth and these are the moon. As we can see the how the these two dates are calculating, that this is the sun, this is earth, and this is the moon. So the sun rotates, Earth rotates around the sun in 365 days. So we can call it as a solar calendar, which are referring as per the solar calendar. And once the moon is rotating around the Earth, once it complete the 12 rotation around the Earth, suppose it start Earth moving around here, the moon completes the rotation before the 11 days once the sun solar calendar completes. So you can say that 354 days once the solar calendar complete, the lunar calendar 1 year complete. So we can say that 354 days lunar calendar has the 1 year and solar calendar has the 365 days. So total difference between these two calendars 11 days in 1 year between the lunar calendar and between the solar calendar. So these are the basic point that we want to say. Then we will go with the date. And again, in the Quran, it has been mentioned 1587, where it is described about the seven pairs. And we will see what is the seven pairs is mentioned in the verse of 1587. Here it is mentioned 1587. We have given you the seven pairs in the Great Quran. So the seven pairs is described here. We will see the Wikipedia. There are total 114 verses in the Quran, and some of the verses which starts with the mutukat isolated letters. So in Al-Fatiha Surah first, there are no isolated letters, but in Surah Baqarah there are Alif, Lam, Mim. These are the three letters. Start with these three letters, which has no meaning, but it started with that isolated letter, so it is actually the mathematical structures behind that, and it reveals the code where God is describing that how he has counted each and every letter, so we cannot even displace the single letter out of the Quran. So there are total out of the 114 surahs, there are 29 surahs which start with this type of isolated letters, which we can say mukattat. And these 29 surahs out of the 104, we will see here there are third surah also start with Alif Lam Mim, and seventh surah start with Alif Lam Mim and Saad, and there are 10 surahs which start with, likewise if we go it, there are total 29 surahs where there is the huruf-e-mutukat letters. And the last surah, and we can see that there are the big letter in surah 19 where kaf, ha, ya, en, saad. There are five letters been mentioned in that surahs. We can even check it in the Quran itself here, 19 surahs first. How, what is the meaning of that huruf-e-mutukat? As we can see here, the first verse is which says that kaf, ha, ya, en, en, saad. So this is called the huruf-e-mutukat, where five letters, which is actually the no meaning, but it is actually mathematically composed, and the meaning is hidden since it was discovered by the Rashid Khalifa in 1974, that if you count those letters in the surah, it is precisely multiple of the 19. So the same structure here, it is in a Wikipedia, as we can see here, the list of, there are the total like this. The end of that 29, where it ends, noon, surah. Yeah, these are the last 68. After that, you can see there are no in initial letters, as it ends with the noon in a 68 verse. The last surah, it ends with the surah noon here. And later on, there are no any initial or isolated letters. As we can see that it ends with the 114 chapters, and later on there are no any isolated letters with that. So these are the basic explanation before we go that where and how the date of the judgment day is mentioned in the Quran. So we have actually studied the composite and prime number as well as the solar and lunar calendar, and plus we also studied that how these seven pairs and how it is been mentioned that in the Surah 1587 it says that we have given you the seven pairs. So which that seven pairs? As we can see that in all the 29 surahs, these letters, different letters has been mentioned. Like in some surahs, Kaf, Na, Noon, and as we have seen that in 14 surah, Kaf, Ha, Ya, and Saad is been mentioned. So there are seven pairs. So seven pairs, that means 7 into 2. God has given in the Quran total 14 initial pairs. In out of the 29 surah, if you take it all the pairs, then you can get it exactly the 14 pairs like in all 29 surahs. So, and if you count as a geometrical value, as in a previous video we have studied that how the geometrical value can count, and we will look it one more time into the Wikipedia. Again we will open the page in Wikipedia, you can check the absurd numerals. So at the time of 1400 years before, there was no number system. So the communities and the peoples are using to do the transaction, they are using the letters of their number, actually the language and the letters they are using to count the numbers. Then later on the number discovered and that pattern was obsolete. But at that time that number has the particular geometrical values, or you can say the numerical values. So from that numerical values, if you apply and we can count, then it derive the one number systems. Same likewise, we can see that we have checked in the Surah 19, there are 5 letters, and this is the calculators where we can see that if you apply and you can even count the all the letters value as Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ain and Sa. These are the 5 letters, and if we copy and paste those 5 letters, then we get the number value of the 195. So same way this value has been calculated, as you can see here, I will not go to the all the 14 letters, that how it is the derived the letter, but you can see that the total value comes 1709, as God has says in the Quran 1587, we have given you the 7 pairs. So if you count the geometrical value of these 14 letters, then it comes across the 1709, as we have already seen that Kaf, Ya, Ain are 195. We can check the one more Kaf and Noon value in a geometrical value, that what are the values of for the Kaf and Noon. As we can see that the Noon has the 15 value here and Kaf has the 100 values here. So same the value has taken from these tables, and after that we have counted the total values of this for 14 pairs individually, and then we get the one numbers 1709. So these are actually the prime numbers which you cannot divide by any numbers, and you can only divide by one or by itself. So it says the prime number. So now we get the one numbers, and that numbers is related with the date of judgment day, and there are many proofs and evidence that it gives the assurance that God has given this date as a final ultimatum for the human beings, that after once this date cross and once the first date of the 1710 starts, the world will end. So we'll go further and we'll check it that the with this number how it is associated with the date of the judgment. So there are almost 3 to 4 signs at the during, there are the one very old knowns that the time of, you can see here that the Jews of the Medina went to the Prophet and said, your Quran is initial with Alif Lam Mim, and this initial determine the lifespan of your religion. Since Alif is the one, Lam is a teen, Mim is a 40, this meant that your religion will survive only 71 years. So Muhammad said, we also have the Alif Lam Mim and Saad, where the Saad value is the 19. So these add up to 161. So do you have anything else? The Prophet says, yes, we have Alif Lam Mim Rad. So that Rad has a value of 200. So that means 217. So the finally they gave up and saying, we do not know how many of these initial we have he has given. So that means that at the time 1,004 years before, the Muhammad has also given, Muhammad Prophet has also given the sign that these are the 14 pairs, indicates the end of the world, or it can say the judgment day. And also in the Quran, one more sign is given that in that the how it is relating with that numbers. Further that before we will study that how it is correlating with the 19 miracles. Here we can see the surah where it is mentioned 2015, where it is says that the hour is surely coming, I will keep it almost hidden, for each soul must be paid for its works. It is mentioned in the surah 20 and verse 15. We will again look the same numbers here. And we can get this in the surah 20 and verse 15. We can see here the hour is actually coming. So the number it's 2015, which is the composite number. So we will open the composite number, our programs, and we will find the position of this number into that composite number. So this is the composite number program, and I will type here 2020. So we will get all the composite number and its respective index or its respective position of that. So we will get exactly the 2015, and we will see that here that what will be the meaning of this 2015. And so I will type here 2020, and you can see here the all the composite series number since the beginning of the 4 6 2 9 4. So these are the respective 4 number is the first composite number, 6 is the second composite number, 8 is the third composite number. Likewise, we will see the 2015 number where the it has been mentioned about actually says the hour is surely coming, I will keep it almost hidden. So here we can see that 2015, I will mark it out here. You can see here that 1709 is the position of the same here. The composite number position is 1709. See the number here and see the how it is precisely what we previously we have checked the 14 pairs. If you count all the geometrical value of the 14 pair, it comes 1709. These are the first solid proof that it clearly says the date of the judgment, end of the world, it comes once the lunar calendar as per it, once 1709 is completed, it will start. So you can see these are the mathematical structure, it undeniable proof that we are just checking the position of the number systematically, and we get the 2015 composite number and position itself, it is a 1709, which is 1709 is a prime number, and we will see the position of the 1709 into the prime number as well as. So this is the prime number, and I will keep it separately both the, so we will derive it. So actually I put the number here 1711, so whatever the prime numbers up to 1711, it automatically it will calculate as these are the program design, and it gives the index value as well as. So we can see the prime number is less as the composite number are more. So here you can see the position of the 1709, actually this is the prime number, as we can see here from 2, 3, 5, 7 all are the prime numbers, and position also we can see here 267. I will mark it out, and I will again confirm that how the date of the judgment is interconnected. So these are the 2015 where the God is mentioned into the Quran, plus 2015. Here we can see the prime number is the 1709, the position. And we can see here the 1709, the position of the 1709 is 267. So how these two numbers are interconnected, we will again go back to the same tools here. Here we can see that we calculated the composite number till the 66, where 2 to 67, the last arrow camps is the 19. Why I took again 19? Because in the previous video we already described that Wahid, the Arabic words which has the geometrical value 6 plus 1 plus 8 plus 4, 19. So Wahid meanings is the one. So God has actually given his signature that I am the one who created this scripture and I am the one who is protecting it. So we took the all the numbers from 2 to 67 as well as the composite number between 2 to 67. So you can see here that once we count the prime number 1709, the position is 267 as well as, and the 1709 is the position of the verse where it is mentioned the hour is already, the hour is surely coming, I will keep it almost hidden. So here you can see the 2 and 67, where the precisely if you add all the composite number 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 9 till the 66, till the 66, then the total comes 1709. So these are the again second proof. See the how beautifully all the numbers are interconnected. So what I did actually, I will again explain you because this is quite complicated. The prime numbers 2 to 67, there are the 19 positions of the 67 prime number. So what I did, I took the all the composite number from the 2 to 67 between. So these are the 4, 6, 8, all are the composite number. And then later on I added all the composite number 4 plus 6 plus 8, and you can see here the total value prime numbers, it comes around 1709, and the position itself it comes the 267, and the whatever the number we add 2 to 67 all composite number, again the number comes the 1709. So this is the third confirmation here. The all add this all the composite between 2 to 67, 1709, and you check the position of the 1709 as we have already seen here. We will check again that we can see here the position of the 1709 is again 267, and 2 to 67 between, if you count, if you add all the composite number, again this value comes 1709. If you add all the composite number 4 plus 6 plus 8 till the 66, as the 2 to 67 between we counted all the composite number, again this number comes 1709. And again we have seen here the 2015, the position of the 2015 is again 1709. And these are the verses where 20 chapter and 15 verse, it is mentioned about the hidden secret that I have almost kept hidden. So we will check the another confirmation. These are the first evidence that the 1709 is around the date of the judgment is clearly mentioned into the Quran and how it is related with the judgment day. So we have already seen that there are the 7 pairs, and if you count geometrical value the number comes 1709. As well as we read the conversation during the time of the prophet, that this number was actually calculated to the end of the religion or either end of the earth. So and you can say even the it is a judgment day. And the Quran 43:61 verse, it says that Jesus is to serve as a marker for knowing the end of the world, so that you can no longer harbor any doubt about it. We will check the verse and we will see it, what is exactly mentioned about that verse. He is to serve as a marker, the knowing the end of the world, so you can no longer any harbor doubt about it. So it is says about the Jesus in this verse, and how the Jesus is marker the end of the world, we will look at that second point, and we will again confirm the how the 1709 is correlated with debt. So we know that the birth of Jesus and birth of Muhammad, there is a 517 years difference between the birth of Jesus and birth of the Muhammad. As the birth of Jesus, we can say is a 0 AD, and birth of Muhammad is a 570. And the solar calendar and lunar calendar difference is the time of 1710. As before, we have already seen that solar calendars and lunar calendars, there are 11 years difference. So at the time of when the lunar calendar will be 1710, at the time of the solar calendar will be 2280. So if you count the difference between these two, again exactly it comes the 570 years. So as it has been mentioned into the Quran that Jesus is the marker of the end of the world. So this is the marking as the mathematically precisely the end of the world AD, and as per the AD means as per the solar calendar at the time, same time, because 1709. So as the 1710 first Muharram, date of the first Muharram, there will be the judgment day. And if you count the same time, the end of the world, the solar calendar, it will be 2280. And you take the difference between these two, exactly 570 years. Same way, birth of the Jesus and birth of the Muhammad, precisely 570 years difference. So this is the second proof. And we have already seen the previous with the number, how it is correlated with each other. And this is the second proof that the birth of Jesus and birth of Muhammad, as well as the date 1710 with the 2280, as per the solar and lunar calendar difference, exactly comes 570 years. And one more proof we will see in the Quran, verse number 18 and 21. We will check the verse here. This is the verse 18 and 21. What about that verse says and how it is related with the date of judgment? It says that we cause them to be discovered to let everyone know that God's promise is true and to remove all the doubt concerning the end of the world. See here it is precisely says, God says to remove all the doubt concerning the end of the world. The people then disputed among themselves regarding them. Some said, let us build a building around them, their Lord is best knower about them. Those who prevail said, we will build a place of worship around them. So in the same time, the peculiar ways of writing in 1825, we will check the two both verses. It's already 1821, it is says about the end of the world. And what about the 1825? We will open the same verse 1825 after. And here it is says that they stayed in their cave 300 years, increased by 9. As we already knew that 1400 years before, there were no any particular counting of the solar and lunar calendars. So it's pretty hard to count. But here in this verse, it precisely says about the both the solar and exactly the lunar calendar. So you can say this is the one kind of the also the miracles that 1400 years before you can't able to count these all the things. As once actually what this did means 300 and increased by 9. So here it says that once the 300 years solar as per the sun equal to the 309 years of the lunar calendar. As once the 1 year completes, there are 11 days difference, as we have already seen in the previous part, that once the 1 year it comes, there are 11 days difference. So if it is a 300 years, then there will be 300 into 11. So that many days difference, if you divide it by the 365, it comes exactly 9 years difference. So we know that God is the one who created all the planet and solar and all the counting of the days and nights. So he knew that, and he precisely mentioned these numbers in 18 Surah Kaf with the perfection. You can see that how, because due to now technology, we can easily count that there are the difference between the 300 years, exactly the 9 years. But at the time of 1400 years before, it's impossible to count all of these things. But we can see this number is also related with the end of the world, and how it is that we will see again now, that how it is related with the same 1709 numbers, as we have already seen that how it is interconnected with these numbers. As we can see that 1709 to the 1400 has it coincided with the 1980 plus the 300 years, also a multiple of 19. So the time of the once this miracle was discovered by the Rashid Khalifa until the date of it precisely comes 300 and 309 years difference. So once this was discovered, from that date to the till that, it exactly comes again the figure which we have seen here in 1825 verse. 300 increased by the 9 years. So either you count by the solar calendar and either you count by the lunar calendar, it is the exact number, because as the solar and lunar calendars, once the 300 year cross, the lunar calendar becomes the 309 years. And the same difference comes till the discovery of that, the date of the judgment, and exactly it comes between 309 and 300 years. So this is the fourth science, precise science, that 1709 is the marker of the end of the world. And it's mathematically, if you say that, it is undeniable proof. As number you cannot deny, 1 plus 1 equal to 2. And you cannot say that it's 1 plus 1 equal to 3. Same way, it's a very simple mathematical logics behind that. And it's undeniable proof. And God has kept hidden, but he declared it through his one of the his submitters, Rashid Khalifa has discovered this miracle. And at the time, you can see precisely it is matching with the Quran numbers as well. There are many more other miracles we will discuss, and we will study in the next third video, and we will see that how these numbers are more interconnected with the surahs and with the verses. And we can see the solar calendar and the lunar calendar different between the Prophet Muhammad lifespan also, that precisely if you say solar year and lunar year, there are exactly 11 days difference, and we will study in the next video about that one. Hope you enjoy it.